It's the 1st of May. There's a grey. We're grey. Coming into Dongra. We left our lovely camp at Lake Indoon this morning. And coming into Dongra. About to go and have coffee at the coffee tree. Beautiful, beautiful display. The coffee tree at Dongra. Norm sitting at the coffee tree waiting for his coffee and his apple slice. The Dongra crayfish. This is Port Denison at Dongra. Beautiful weather. Here comes the cray boat. And there's Dongra. Here's that cray boat that I saw coming in, unloading his catch. Wow. Cruise ship, we heard an interview on the radio earlier. Yeah. There's a cruise ship. It's doing a circuit of Australia, that one. Nearly 5 o'clock and we're coming down into Kalbarri now. Saturday morning and we've come around to Back Beach at Kalbarri. That's looking back towards Kalbarri. It's in the cove in there. Murchison River comes out there. Lots and lots of cray pots out there. I don't know how the poor old crays ever survived to grow up.
We started feeding the pelicans up here in Kalbarri, back in the early 70s. Now, the fella that started it off, his name was Cliff Ross. Now, back then he used to live across the road in a place called Fantasyland. Well, anyway, like most people up here in Kalbarri, Cliff was a mad keen fisherman. They'd go fishing nearly every morning. And after he'd come back from fishing, he'd come down here and clean his catch. Well, the pelicans used to hang around here quite a bit, so pelicans, real clever birds. Didn't take them long at all to realise, oh, you beauty, free breakfast. So they'd meet him down here. Now, the mornings that Cliff was late, oh, heaven forbid, didn't roll up here at all. Oh, like I said, pelicans are real clever birds. They knew where he lived. They'd mark across the road and they'd bang on his doors and windows with their beaks. Come on, Cliff, wake up. Where's our breakfast? Anyway, back then, Grey Street here, that was the only road in and out of Kalbarri. So on those odd mornings, we had the odd pelican run over. Not so good. Hence this lovely little corral. We've been feeding the pelicans here ever since. Fortunately though, Cliff is no longer with us, but he has left this little legacy for us all to enjoy. Let's see if Barry can entice her up here. What do you reckon?
She will
fade.
Hey!
She will fade.
Oh, another one coming down. Oh, a couple more coming down.
Thank you very much.
Come on up, get down.
Oh,
see, I got that one.
Oh, he got it.
Didn't he? All sorts of marines. Now, I quite often go down there myself and do a bit of time. You've got a bit of clearance today here. There's two better beaches to go to. Okay, so if you get a chance, go up there.
We're on our way to one of the lookouts at the loop in the Kalbarri lookout. That's a big snake has gone through here. A big snake has gone through here. Look at that. Murchison River Gorge in Kalbarri National Park from one of the lookouts at the loop. Some wave rock. This is called Nature's Window. This is an arthropod track left in prehistoric times when arthropods ruled. This is to the south of Kalbarri, only just. Looking at the Indian Ocean and looking north all the way up to Shark Bay if you had a good enough eye. This is looking south, just out of Kalbarri at a place called Pot Alley. That's looking back towards Kalbarri from Pot Alley. It's a natural bridge. Castle Cove. That's supposed to be a shell house. I'm struggling to see it through the flies.